Today I'm talking about my Shogun Inferno. The Shogun Inferno is both a monitor and an external recorder. The whole reason I bought the Shogun was I wanted to be able to record 4K at 60 frames per second in 10-bit. I own the FS5, and internally the FS5 just records 4K at 30 frames per second in 8-bit. Right here are the specs, so feel free to pause the video and take a look. The Shogun Inferno can record 4K at up to 60 frames per second in both ProRes and DNxHR. It can also record raw DNG files at up to 30 frames per second in 4K. The Shogun Inferno has an amazing monitor and is just really inspiring to shoot with. It makes your shots look great, and I really haven't worked with a better monitor. It also has a lot of exposure tools and monitoring tools like histogram, false color, focus peaking, vector scopes, pretty much anything that you want is on here. They really thought through what are people gonna use when they shoot and incorporated all of those different things. Say you're planning to finish your project as a 2:3:5 aspect ratio. You can throw frame guides on that so you're shooting and composing your shots in the right aspect ratio. There's also a lot of other aspect ratios available, including 4:3. The other great thing that the Shogun Inferno can do is it has anamorphic D-squeeze built in to the monitor. So if you're shooting on anamorphic lenses, you don't have to look at the image squeezed, it will de-squeeze it in the monitor. If you shoot S-Log2 or S-Log3, C-Log, or any of the log profiles on these cameras, it kind of sucks to have to shoot with that log profile and have to look at that while you're shooting. With these Atomos monitors, you can download LUTs and shoot with those LUTs, and you can have an option of baking the LUT into the video file, or you can just shoot with that LUT and view it on set like that, and then when you bring the file in to edit, it'll still be in log. Everything that you need is really easy to access, and the touchscreen works great to get at everything. A really great thing about the Shogun Inferno is that it records onto SSDs, and compared to other types of media, like say the media the RED cameras use, SSDs are really affordable. These are the same sort of SSDs that you would put into your computer. The biggest negative with this device is the battery life. One battery in good weather will last you about 45 minutes, and when I've been shooting in the cold, in the winter, one battery sometimes will only last me a couple takes, 20 minutes or so, 15 minutes before I have to swap it. Turning the monitor off is kind of a pain. Instead of just hitting the power button on the side, you're actually supposed to go into the menu and then press and hold the power off button for what it says is 3 seconds. And it seems like it's really more like 10 seconds, which is a ridiculous amount of time to have to be pressing and holding a button to turn the monitor off. Build quality on the Shogun really isn't that great. I feel like if I dropped it, it would shatter into a million pieces. Compared to something like the Odyssey 7Q, it's just not that well put together. It also isn't really weather sealed. There's vents on the top, and I get nervous when I'm filming in weather, you know, slight drizzle or snow. That water's gonna get in and wreck the internal components. It just doesn't feel very firm in your hands, and for something that you're paying $2,000+ for, I think it really should be better. It's not like a small monitor, it's pretty thick, and once you put batteries on there and stuff, you know, you're looking at a pretty heavy unit. So just putting it on your camera, it's gonna add quite a bit of weight, and it's gonna be a little bit bulky and awkward. Overall, I've just kind of learned to work with it. I really do like it. I think it's worth the extra weight. So I hope that little review was helpful, and I'll see you guys later.